Good morning. The thing that is on my mind this morning is how important it is for all of us to stand up when we see a woman bullying another woman in the workplace. There have been a few situations in the last couple of months that have really brought this top of mind to me. I wish this was a thing of the past, but the truth is it is not, and it is up to all of us to take a stand so that we don't allow this behavior to continue and escalate. So let's talk about a couple of things you can do when you see a woman treating another woman with disrespect in the workplace. And obviously this works for both genders. I am particularly sensitive to the woman-on-woman bullying because it is, in my opinion, more aggressive, more egregious, and just more demeaning than what I see between men or between men and women. All right, let's talk about the things that we can all do to get rid of bullying in the workplace. The first one is, if you're the one who is being treated in a bad way, stand up for yourself and set your boundaries. And you can do it in a very respectful way. You can say something like, "Sarah, I don't speak to you this way, and I'm going to ask you to not treat me with disrespect." Very clear, very strong boundaries. And if she continues, then I want you to walk out. You can say, "I'm not going to continue this conversation until you can treat me with respect." Get up and walk out of the room. You have a right to do that. You do not need to sit there and take abusive behavior. If you're in the room when this is happening, let's say it's between Sarah and Sally, and you are in the room and you witness it, then you can use that language and say, "Sarah, we're not gonna tolerate this kind of treatment in the workplace. I'm gonna ask you to be respectful to Sally." Talk about it, say what is on your mind, and then talk to, if you are the person who is witnessing it, talk to the abuser and let her know that it's your responsibility to share what you saw with her supervisor, and then follow up and share it with the supervisor. In the case where it is egregious, I am going to encourage the person who is being bullied to go to HR and report it, because chances are you are not the only person that this woman who is doing the bullying is treating poorly. Typically, bullies don't pick one person to pick on, they pick on everyone. And particularly people who fit a certain demographic or a certain personality type. And if you don't stand up and let your HR folks know that this is happening, it is going to continue. And for my leaders, stop the behavior immediately. Don't let it continue. I know sometimes it's uncomfortable and we don't quite know what to do when it starts. Simply stopping and saying, "Sarah, this is not how we talk to each other here. I am going to end the meeting and I'll call you afterwards," is a great way to stop that bullying from happening. You know, when I first went into corporate, oh gosh, that must be 30 years ago now, this was prevalent. It was a normal way that women in leadership treated other women. And I have been so fortunate to also work with some amazing woman leaders and have so much respect for the women in my life who lead with empathy and kindness. It is all of our responsibility to stand up when we see the opposite behavior and allow the other women in our organizations to know that they have a safe place, that we've got her back, and that we're not going to tolerate bullying in the workplace. Remember, when you stand up to bullying, this is a way that you will rise and you will teach others how to rise as well.